Hello everyone. So today in this video I will show you how you can make paratha just in simple ways. We have our ingredients here, as you can see. I have my flour here. So in this video I will use half batch. In this I mean 1.5 kg. Initially we normally use one full batch, but today I will use half batch. That means if I put it on a weighing scale, it will be 1500 grams. So this is my 1500 grams, 1.5 kg. This is my flour, 1.5 kg. I have here my sugar, 60 grams. If it is one batch, it should be 120 grams. I have my milk. If it is a full batch, it should be 200 grams, but since it is half batch, I use 100 grams. I have my salt. If it is full batch, I use 70 grams, but half batch, I use 35 grams. I have my eggs. We use eggs also when I'm making my paratha. I use eggs. If it is full batch, we use three eggs, because in each and every keg it should be one piece. But since I am making one half batch, I have to use I'm going to use 2 pieces, because half batch I cannot divide the two egg yolks, which means I have to just use 2 pieces, full 2 pieces, because I cannot divide the egg yolks. So these are my eggs I'm going to use in my paratha. So still I have my oil, acyl oil. It is here. This one you can use as much as possible, because I will have to dissolve it on fire in order to get the liquid state. I will have to dissolve it. This is the acyl oil. This is the acyl oil, the one I'm talking about. It will be like this, acyl oil. It gives the paratha a great taste. I have my water also. My water is here. I measure it. But we measure our water in grams, not in liters. If it is full batch, it should be 1657 grams. But I have to divide it into half and I get 828 grams. This is my 828 grams, the one I will use in my half batch of paratha. Watch carefully. So when you go to the procedure, we have to first mix dry ingredients together, that is salt, flour and sugar. You have to mix the three ingredients together so that in each and every corner of our flour, but those two items are all in. You have to make sure that it's all mixed very well. Let me put everything now, the three ingredients together. This is my sugar, 4 my salt. So I have to mix this one very well. After mixing my dry ingredients, I'll add, next will be the liquid ingredients. These ones I'll have to mix. Now I'll have to mix the eggs into milk. I'll put my eggs, the 2 pieces here, so that I can first mix the egg yolks together. I have to mix it very well. Watch carefully. Let me first mix it. So you
can see that I have mixed it very well. Next step is to put it into my dry ingredients. By our water. So I have to mix this very well. So after I've mixed my flour very well,
you see I've mixed it very well. So the next step is to add acyl oil. Remember I told you acyl oil gives your paratha a great taste. If you eat, you feel that the taste is so different from some of the paratha you'll find on the way. So I'll add my acyl oil here. So I'll try to dissolve my acyl oil on fire. You have to dissolve it in order to get this taste, because you cannot use it the way I showed you at first. You cannot use it like that. It's better to first dissolve it so that you can use it in your dough. So let me try to get some dry food in my dough. Get your acyl oil, put in dough like this. Always use gloves in order to avoid any kind of contamination.
Any other kind of food as you're dealing with the paratha, it's better to always remove your gloves, change the gloves. So I've mixed my dough very well. Now the next step is to let it rest. I'm going to rest it for 10 minutes. I'll come back. Well, our 10 minutes have elapsed. So I have to open my dough. So I'm going to cut it now in two pieces. So now I have to make my holes. After I've cut my paratha, I've made my balls, as you can see. So the next step, I have to put some flour, a little bit of flour on top. After putting the flour, I can rest it for 8 minutes, not less than 8 minutes. If you leave it for not less than 8 minutes, it will calm down. The 8 minutes will help you to calm down, because if you start rolling this one, it will just break, and it will even not move. But if you leave it rest, it will calm down. So I have to leave it rest. I can cover. Let me get a clean film and I cover. Mostly I can cover with my bowl, the one I used to make. Cover it very well. 8 minutes. After I'll start drawing it in order to get my final balls. It's from those final balls that I'll get my paratha. after rolling my balls very well, so I have to put it on pan for cooking. So it's time to cook my paratha. I have to keep shaking. Because it does not burn down. I have to keep monitoring my paratha very well. So our paratha should look like this. Should always look like this. Like that. Thanks for viewing. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more educating videos.